Once we have become masters at using plasma DNA genomics for genotyping our lung cancer patients, we start thinking, how can we use these technologies next? And we should remember that plasma DNA has actually been used as a diagnostic for many years in medicine for pregnant women, where we look in the free-floating DNA for characteristics of the fetus to look for fetal abnormalities, okay? And that is really a detection strategy. We're not genotyping, we're looking for signals. That means, these blood tubes are everywhere. There are huge applications across medicine. The new idea we're using more and more is, can we use this cell-free DNA not to genotype a cancer, but to actually detect a cancer in a patient at risk of cancer? And that's a whole nother area of development. These are diagnostics being developed in patients who are cured of their cancer, looking for residual cancer, and in patients who might be screening for cancer. And so this relates to a recent publication we put out in collaboration with a company called GRAIL. These are the results of the CCGA study, the Circulating Cancer Genotyping Atlas, Circulating Cancer Genomics Atlas, where we are looking through the free-floating DNA for signals of cancer and trying to figure out in cancer patients, can we identify a diagnostic that reliably finds cancer that's not present in non-cancer patients? This is a big study, enrolled 15,000 individuals. Initially, we looked at three different ways of analyzing the free-floating DNA: mutations, like we use in liquid biopsies, amplifications, copy number variation, like you use in prenatal screening in pregnant women, and methylation signatures, which is sort of the new kid on the block. And actually, what we found is that those methylation signatures were the most reliable way of finding cancer and figuring out what kind of cancer you had found. And so what we built was this targeted methylation panel that we then launched in a recent validation paper, and we published this in Annals of Oncology, showing that with this targeted methylation panel, we could detect huge numbers, many different types of cancers, especially high-risk cancers, with a really high specificity, greater than 99% specificity, so a less than 1% false positive rate. And you could detect a wide range of cancers, easier to find more advanced stage cancers, also can find earlier stage cancers, can find the more hard to find cancers like pancreatic cancer, ovarian cancer. And when you find a cancer signal, you can, using a machine learning algorithm, predict the tumor of origin. And so this gives us an idea, wow, maybe we can actually use these blood tests not just for cancer genotyping, but for cancer detection. We are now launching new studies. We've launched the Pathfinder study working with GRAIL, and we're actually soon to be enrolling at Dana-Farber. And we will be testing patients who are at risk of cancer, offering a blood test on study. And then if those results come back positive, then we work up that result and try to figure out where is the cancer and how to treat it. And so once we sort of pilot how to use these blood tests in patients on controlled studies, our hope is, over the coming time, we will be able to offer these tests actually more broadly as a way of screening for cancer if we can find and show that they are safe and effective. And so that research is unrolling and hopefully is, coming to a center near you. This research could be available.